And let's bring in Dr. Ashish Jha. He's the Dean of Brown University School of Public Health. Dr. Jha, good morning to you. I'm sure you are looking at these numbers with alarm. What is concerning you most about the surge that we're seeing right now?
So good morning, Savannah. Thank you for having me on. What concerns me most is how widespread this is, that this is affecting every part of the country, from the Northeast to the South to the upper Midwest. There really is no part of the nation that is spared from this outbreak at this moment. And that makes it a true national emergency in a way that you could argue we haven't seen before.
How do you explain this latest surge? Is it a function of cooler weather? I mean, can you point to any one factor?
Yeah, I think cooler weather certainly is a factor. But to me, the biggest issue here probably is just pandemic fatigue. I think people are getting tired of the restrictions. And also, we're seeing a lot of letdown in the policies, opening up of some bars and restaurants in states. All of that, I think, is contributing to what is going on across the nation.
Cases are up. That's the bad news. The good news is that since the pandemic began, doctors have gotten a lot better at treating COVID. Do you anticipate better outcomes than, say, we had had in the springtime?
I do, or I certainly hope that is going to be the case. You know, I do think that the average person infected today is less likely to die, but we're still seeing 1,000 Americans dying every single day. So while that is improvement from what would have been had we not gotten better, still a lot of people getting very, very sick and a lot of people dying from this disease.
Are you concerned about healthcare systems in various places around the country not being prepared for the wave that's coming?
Well, you know, I really was confident that we were going to do better this time. Already yesterday, we saw in Utah a declaration that they may not be able to care for everybody and are going to start triaging based on age. I did not think we were ever going to get to a point where we were going to deny people care in the ICU based on age or how sick they are. If that's starting to happen already, and we have many, many weeks of this surge to go, I am starting to get concerned that we may get into trouble.
All right. Dr. Jha, it's always good to talk to you, even though it's hard to hear sometimes. Thank you very much. We really appreciate it.